I'm Maria Menounos, and you're tuned in to AfterBuzz TV, the ESPN of TV talk. Now, let the buzz begin.
Hi! Hi, everyone. Happy Thursday, and welcome to Soap News Weekly. We are AfterBuzz TV's entertainment news for all of your favorite soap operas. I am Tami Goveia.
And I am Chelsie Overocker.
Welcome again, you guys. You know, we've made it really easy for all of you to follow us on social media. Soap News Weekly can be found on Facebook, on Twitter, and on Insta at where?
Soap News Weekly.
Ta-da! So easy.
Yes.
Please follow and engage. It's actually been great. We've posted some, General Hospital fans have been super responsive on our Instagram profile about the stuff that we've been posting. And so thank you, GH fans, for being so engaged and so involved. And thank you all fans for continuing to support this very young show of ours.
Yes.
We appreciate it. Also, if you're a podcast listener, Soap News Weekly is also a podcast. So head over to Apple Podcasts, find Soap News Weekly, and add us to your favorite podcast list. Because everyone's got like five or six that they love.
Of course.
So we hope you love us. Hey, what's going on in the chat room before we get into the news?
We have Dwight, Annie. Oh,
our favorites.
Jenny,
some of our favorites.
Kenneth.
Hey, Annie. How's your mom doing?
Yes, I've been getting your tweets, Annie.
Keep us posted, Kenneth. And yes, hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us. It was a really good week. What did you think about it?
Really great
week.
Yeah. And we had some last minute posts today, too.
I know.
That we wanted to throw in there last minute, but really great.
Well, let's get into all the good stuff.
Sounds great.
Okay. We will start with The Bold and the Beautiful. Ha! We just love doing that.
I know. We have so much fun.
I know. Yes. I need to have a wig, and then we need a fan blowing, and then our hair just...
Oh, that would be great.
So we get the whole Forrester creation.
Did you say have a
dynamic.
Wig on?
Me.
Oh,
yeah.
You.
I don't have any hair to blow.
And then I'll just go off. That's my worst nightmare if I wear a wig.
Let's start with Lawrence St. Victor, everyone. Of course, he plays the lovable and wonderful Carter on The Bold and the Beautiful, and... You know, whenever James and I do recap The Bold Breakdown, we're always complaining that Lawrence doesn't get enough airtime.
Right.
But it looks like he's going to be back on the canvas and with a possible love interest with the actress Kiara Barnes, who plays Zoe on The Bold and the Beautiful, which is good. I know you don't watch B&B, but I watch B&B and I am loving that concept.
That's a good combo.
He would be great with anybody on the cast.
Well, just looking at him,
I think he would be really great. With anybody on the cast, but we're so happy he's going to be coming back, and we're hoping for some really good storylines. This is a really good tidbit, everyone. So the actor Andreas Georgiou, so he's from the UK, but he's primarily known for his production and his work as an actor and producer in Greece. He stars in a very famous soap opera in Greece called Lex's Eight, and it looks like he's going to be on The Bold and the Beautiful. It probably aired this past week, but he plays the doctor Sally Spector, who's one of the characters played by Courtney Hope, is sick. You know, she doesn't know what's wrong with her. So Andreas Georgiou is the doctor who she's consulting with. And the fun piece of news about this is Catherine Kelly Lang did an episode of his soap opera in Greece, Lex's Eight. I think it was toward the end of last year. And so now he is showing up on The Bold and the Beautiful. So I love that. I love, you know, you pay it forward and you just try to support, you know, the actors in the community and... Come on my soap opera. Sure, come on my soap opera.
That is awesome.
I think that's fantastic. Speaking of fantastic, you know, Carla Moseley is truly, I'm not going to say one of the most talented because everyone in daytime is just like weirdly talented. But, you know, Carla's one of those, she sings, she acts, she directs, she writes. And it looks like she is going to be in a musical.
Really?
Yes. Wow. So the IAMA Theater Company's upcoming production of the musical Found. Now, starring in this is Wicked alumni Jonah Platt, who apparently will take the role of the lead named Davey. Also joining is Jordan Kai Burnett and Mike Millen, rounding out the main cast. Found's previews begin on February 14th, and the show will open on February 20th. So if you are interested in tickets, please go to ci.ovationtix.com. That's through the Los Angeles Theater Center. Again, that's ci.ovationtix.com. Go get some tickets.
Do it.
Support live theater. That's what we always say.
It's amazing.
There's a lot in Los Angeles. People don't take advantage of it. There's a lot of really good live theater in Los Angeles.
And very talented actors.
Yes. And of course, we have Miss Catherine Kelly Lang in the news. We had reported last week that one of the films she had worked on is Stan the Man. And we just heard that they are actually having the red carpet premiere this weekend.
Good for them.
This weekend is the red carpet premiere. Now, this is starring Stephen Chase, who also wrote and directed Stand the Man, and he acts in it as well. This is a full-on comedy, and it's going to be fun to see Catherine in a completely different niche. You know, a lot less of the bold and the beautiful drama and some fun comedy stuff.
That'll be great to see her in that role.
Because she can do anything, so this will be fun. So congratulations, everyone, on the red carpet premiere. And once we know where it's airing, you know, if it's going to be a theatrical release or if it's going to be streaming, we will absolutely let you know. And another thing we want to let you know is this Sunday, James Law Jr. and I are back on the Bold Breakdown. Yes, we're excited. There's so much going on. And so the Bold Breakdown is on Sunday, 2:15 p.m. It's our recap here at AfterBuzz TV for The Bold and the Beautiful. So join us and spread the word, please. It's going to be fun.
Thanks, Tami.
You're welcome.
Okay, time to get into some days of our lives.
I sip my hot chocolate.
Yes.
Put my blankie on.
Have you been watching this week?
Yeah, I haven't seen anything yet.
Okay, neither have I.
Okay, good. Okay, good.
But I'll get caught up. Okay, well, Tami, a fan tweeted Wally Kurth, "Thank you for posting this glaring. There's something missing. Now we have to get back to this time." And that's Judy Evans.
Yes.
Wally Kurth retweeted and replied, "Rest assured, Judy Evans is coming back."
Oh, my gosh. And, you know, we kind of had an inkling that that was going to be the case.
Yeah.
We thought, okay, it's horrible that Adrian is gone.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Rolfe wasn't able to find the pulse of life.
The spark.
The spark of life in her. However, we thought, well, you know, there's Bonnie.
So Bonnie.
There's Bonnie, and she's fabulous. Great character, so.
Well, I'm just glad to see Judy back on the canvas.
I know, I'm so happy.
Another person that's staying on the canvas, this is last-minute news, but Paul Telfer posted on Instagram earlier today of him walking down memory lane of the hallway on the Days of Our Lives set, and he commented, "In celebration of NBC Days renewal announcement, here's me leaving the studio after shooting potentially my last scene ever."
Everybody freaked out when they read this.
They thought, okay, does that mean Paul's leaving? No, it was just him going back in time.
Yes.
Of him potentially.
I hope so, too. We hope so.
Paul, don't freak us out.
Yeah.
And, you know, so many fans engaged with it, too. They're like, no, Xander cannot leave. So, Paul, you got some fans.
If you happen to be watching right now, if you could just clarify that, you know, Xander is going to continue with more trouble, we would appreciate that.
Yes.
Okay?
Please let us know.
Thank you.
And Drake Hogestyn celebrates his anniversary on Days.
Oh, my gosh.
So Drake first appeared January 24th in 1986.
Fantastic.
And
oh, my God.
He was known as The Pawn.
Yeah. Well, he has like 7 identities on that show through the years.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
crazy.
And when he first came on, he was heavily bandaged, had memory loss, facial reconstructive surgery. But congrats, Drake, on the anniversary.
Yes.
Great to see you. It's been
love you so much.
34 years. In 1986.
That's amazing. That's fantastic.
Great.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary. This is fun. Jackie Harry wants to kick it with the Days of Our Lives. So Jackie got her first television role on Another World. During the 62nd annual Grammy, Carrie tweeted, has Bonnie Raitt been moonlighting as Maggie from
That's
Days of Our Lives for the past 20 years? And then the head writer of Days, Ron Carlovati, replied back, no, Bonnie's obviously Maggie's evil twin.
There you go.
The real question is, when is Sandra Clark going to come visit Salem?
Make it happen.
We need to make this happy. Jack replied, ha, I would love to play with the dual cast. And Ron tweets back, I'll have my people call your people.
Because that's how it's done in L.A.
Yes, it is.
I'll have my people call your peeps.
Well, I would love to see her on Days. That
Absolutely.
Would be awesome. Another thing you should check out is our after show that we have on Sunday. It's at 3:15 p.m.
It's a great recap.
It's a great
days.
Recap.
Join
days.
Us. Storylines are crazy right now.
It is.
General Hospital. Oh, my gosh, guys.
Wow.
So Jenner Hospital, we have actually a couple of new faces that are on the canvas.
Yeah.
Actor Johnny Wachter, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, Johnny. If I'm not, I apologize. He's going to be playing the character of Brando Corbin, who we thought was dead, but I guess is alive.
Yeah.
So bravo for Johnny. Looking forward to once Jenner Hospital starts airing the episodes. Because I think originally he was scheduled for Wednesday, 22nd.
Okay.
So... Johnny, congratulations. We can't wait to see what trouble you're going to get into. Also, Philip K. Boyd is going to be joining General Hospital. He's going to be playing one of Sonny Corinthos' warehouse foremen. Excited to have these new faces. And Matt Cohen, Dr. Griffin Monroe, everyone, you remember him. He left GH, went on to host for Entertainment Tonight. But guess what? He's also doing some directing, and he's going to be directing an episode of Supernatural. So he posted on Instagram a little bit of what he truly feels in regards to being a director on Supernatural. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look.
You want to know how I feel? Woo! That's how I feel.
Well, that's how I feel. And that's how we feel. We can't wait to see him as a director.
Yeah.
That's so exciting. So exciting.
Good for him.
Last bit for GH, Maurice Bernard. He's going to be at the Improv in Irvine at a fan event. This is going to be February 29th, which is a day before his birthday. So go check him out, fans. Wish him an early birthday. Again, that's going to be the Irvine Improv. You can go to improv.com for tickets and information. More information, recap for GH here at AfterBuzz TV is on Sundays at 6:15 p.m. Make sure and check out the GH report.
And let's get into some Y&R.
Oh, yes.
Our smoothing theme song. You hit your note this time.
Thank you.
Yes.
I practice all week.
Yeah. One of the very many talents you have. Okay. Well, Lauralee Bell and Michelle Stanford were celebrating the new store opening for H Plus E Goods Company in LA. Lauralee commented on Instagram, H Plus E Good Company is a place to find the greatest home gifts a perfect day. And this is good. I got to check this out because
yeah.
I'm all about decorating.
The store looks amazing.
It looks great.
It just looks organic and just really the good products that support, you know, leave a light footprint.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really awesome. So, good for her. A few Y&R cast members will be attending the 7th Annual Opportunity on Sunday, April 5th.
Did you get that, podcast listeners?
Opportunity.
T-E-A.
T-E. Okay, anyway, so members who will be attending is Sharon Case, Mark Grossman, Brian James, and Kate Linder. So be sure to check that one out. And it is confirmed Y&R will be renewed for four more years. Not one, two, three, but four.
That's amazing.
That's awesome.
I wish all the soaps could get guaranteed 4 years.
Well,
come on.
Yes.
Come on, guys.
Need this. And Hunter King shared on Instagram, thank you so much, CBS, Sony, and of course, all the viewers for
yes.
this opportunity. So
great.
Speaking of viewers, if you guys want to view our after show, we have it on Sundays. It's The Restless Wrath at 5:15 p.m.
And we just have one bit of alumni news. We got the sad news that daytime actress Marge Ducey passed away on Tuesday, January 28th. I mean, she's iconic in daytime television. Guiding Light alumni Crystal Hunt posted a really beautiful photo of them together because they both worked on the Guiding Light. But Marge was on Capitol. She played Pamela Capwell on Santa Barbara. Vivian Alamein on Days of Our Lives. My favorite, she played the evil Vanessa Bennett on All My Children. So our thoughts and our prayers are with Marge's family at this time. She will be missed. She was such a dynamic force on the daytime canvas.
That's good. Well, good for them.
You know, you can go on YouTube and you can get all those wonderful episodes and check it out.
Well, she was very involved too with the soap community.
Oh my gosh, very active.
Yeah,
you know, a lot of fundraisers and just promoting daytime television in general. Yeah, she was a voice, and she will be missed.
She will be very missed.
She will be missed. Well, we also have some exciting news to share with you, everyone. We have in studio with us Mr. Blake Berris. Hi!
How are you guys?
We're good.
Good.
How are you?
Very well.
Did you see all the applause?
I know.
I did, the fans are
everywhere.
Going crazy.
Yeah, you know, there's a large studio audience right now, everyone, of about, I don't know, 200 people.
200, 300 people,
right?
I would say, easily.
Yeah. Hashtag goals.
And for you watching, you guys, he played Nick on Days of Our Lives. You first appeared as the nerdy character, and you had a love interest with Chelsie Brady.
Yes, I did.
And then you went off the canvas for a little bit.
I went to jail.
You went to jail.
Yes.
And then you came back, and then you had a new love interest with Gabby Hernandez.
Yeah, that's right.
And that was the downfall.
That was the downfall from there.
Yeah, that took him out. That was like...
Because you turned a dark corner right after that, and then you went really down because you got killed off.
Yeah, Nick had a lot of dark corners, and ended up dead in an alleyway.
Well, how was that experience going from playing this nerdy character to someone really dark?
I loved it. I mean, I liked the really dark direction that it ended up taking because I think that, I don't know, I think I've always just been attracted to roles where it's challenging to figure out what's going on with this person and how to rationalize it. Because, you know, sometimes it gets a little boring just, you know, just playing versions of yourself and that sort of thing. And the kind of further out on the ledge that the role takes me, I think the higher the challenge and the more exhilarating I find it.
Oh, good. No, that was cool seeing you as that playing that role, though.
I know we've got folks in the chat room, and Kenneth says, "Hey, Blake, you were so great as Nick. Do you keep in touch with anyone from Days?"
Well, yeah, I keep in touch with a lot of people, especially because I'm about to make this film about this, you know, soap opera fan event. So I've been back in touch with a lot of people. But, you know, Kate Mancy was at my wedding, who obviously played Abby on Days. Mm-hmm. Rachel Melvin, who played Chelsie, was at my wedding. Galen and I are still in touch. Jordy.
That's fantastic.
A lot of friends from
It's a tight-knit community.
I message with Christian all the time on
Do
Instagram.
Do you really?
And that's what I love about the soap community is even if you're off the canvas, people will still stay in contact with you and bring you on other projects too. And that's what we were just talking about with the Bold and the Beautiful.
Yes.
It's like going to college together or something. Like
yes.
It bonds you in this kind of very serious way.
And the daytime, I mean, the soap opera world is very niche.
Yeah. You know, it's insular. Yeah.
You know, it's almost like being in the military. Like, nobody can really understand what you've experienced unless you're in it.
It's absolutely
That's
true.
That's so true.
Yeah. I like your cups. I like these soap cups.
Can I get one of those? You can get one of these. We'll give you the name, Tony. She does Sweet Tea Customs. You can find her on Instagram.
I like it.
Sweet Tea Customs 3 on Insta, but we'll make sure and hook you up. She does amazing stuff.
I like it.
Isn't that fun?
Yeah, it's really cool.
Let's get into Fangirl.
Let's dig in.
Because this is, when you were telling us about the concept of it, it's like,
it makes total sense. I think it was kind of staring at me in the face for a lot of years, and I didn't realize it. Because there was a point where a buddy of mine and I went to Atlanta, actually with the DP that is going to be the DP of Fangirl. And we started doing a documentary, and I think we didn't even know what we wanted to do, but we just found these soap opera fan events so intriguing, and so like there was just so much there that was inspiring us. And I think we didn't even know what we wanted to do with it, but And nothing ever had it happened with it at the time, but we ended up shooting a lot of footage, and I kind of kept going back to the footage, and he started making a doc on Brian Dottillo that kind of didn't end up like...
He's a lot of fun. I'm sure that was a really fun...
It was fascinating. Brian is amazing, and... But anyway, and then, you know, I started writing Lifetime movies kind of on the side, and I have kind of some other writing projects that I've been hired to write and that sort of thing. But I wanted to write something on my own, and, you know, it was hard for me to figure out, like, you know, what's unique about me at all?
Write what you know.
And I was just like, I don't know, like, you know, this being on a soap opera and having attended all of these fan events... I always felt like a fly on the wall in a way, and weird, I don't know if you can swear on this show, but like weird shit goes down at these things, you know?
Can you give an example? Yeah.
Look, like the fans are getting wasted, the stars are getting wasted, like everyone drinks themselves into oblivion by the end.
The Golden Globe Awards.
Yeah. Like,
it is. Yeah, totally. It gets sloppy. And basically, like, everyone starts out, like, you start at the Q&A, and everyone's like, hi, yes, like, you're fielding questions. And then, like, you're doing this picture and autograph sessions, and people get a little closer. And then there's the VIP dinner, and people get a little closer. And then the cocktail party, and everyone just is getting canned. And, like, and by the end of it, there's a weird thing. So, you know, there was just a lot of, like, I just felt like at a certain point it was staring at me in the face, like, a lot of what's in the movie I made up, but it's all based on real things that have either happened to me.
Yeah, you've got it.
Yeah, and things that I've seen happen to other people, so.
How long did it take you to write this project?
It's been 2 years that, from when I first pressing the buttons on the keyboard in order to write it to where it is now, and a lot of drafts, but the loose structure of it has been the same, which is really simple. It's just the structure of a fan event. This fan takes off on a road trip with a friend that she met in a Facebook group who she doesn't know, but they get to know each other kind of through this experience. And, you know, the whole movie takes place in 24 hours, and she's this woman, Mercy, who's the fan. Who's played by the brilliant Jen Tulloch, we just did a film that was at Sundance last year called Before You Know It, with Alec Baldwin and Judith Light and Mandy Patinkin and Jen.
Oh my gosh, that's an insane cast.
It's such a good cast.
Holy
Everyone should
mackerel.
See the movie Before You Know It. It's streaming on
Before
Apple.
Before You Know It, okay.
And so Jen is one of the leads. I'm in it as well. And she's incredible. She's about to announce some very, very big news about a new show that she's about to be on, which is exciting for us too, because she's just about to take off. But basically, the Mercy character, you know, goes through the gamut of what I just told you, the whole series of events at a fan event, and
so she's a super fan.
She's a super fan.
Okay, she's not just a fan, because there are different levels.
She's a super fan.
She's a super fan.
She's a super fan, and she's also at like a moment of crisis in her life. She's never been to a fan event before. She kind of on a whim decides to like drain her bank account, buy a bunch of things from the shopping mall, dye her hair blue, and like go to this fan event in order to meet her favorite actor. And, you know, it's like it's a journey. It's an odyssey that gets weirder as the movie goes on and as things become more intoxicated. And, you know, the filmmaking will kind of reflect that as well.
Why did you choose a 24-hour
I guess most of the fan events just are. I mean, the ones that are out of town. Originally, we were going to shoot in Louisville. But then I found this hotel in LA, which we're still locking things down, but we're going to announce it soon where this fan event in the movie is going to be shot. And I fell in love with this hotel, and I was like, we could totally shoot it here. And we had already raised enough money to do it. I realized here without having to fly people back and forth to Louisville. And I didn't think we lost anything story-wise by setting it in LA. In fact, it kind of gave it this, it's in Hollywood sort of thing.
Yeah, you can add that dream,
the glamour of
Hollywood.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And you mentioned that you write for Lifetime in the past.
Yeah.
And they're a little bit more serious. So this had to be a fun experience to be able to write, because this kind of sounds like it's going to be a comedy.
Is it a dark comedy? It's a dark comedy.
It's a dark comedy. Okay.
That's the vibe I'm getting.
It's a dark comedy. Yeah. So, I mean, there's stuff. I mean, you know, it's funny stuff goes down at these things. So, you know, there's lots of things to laugh at and with. But it goes to darker realms as well. But I think hopefully we're laughing during some of those too.
Well, you know, I think laughing during those dark moments is kind of, it's just a human reaction.
That's what life's all about, right? I mean,
it's like, okay, this happened. All right.
And there'll probably be some uncomfortable laughing in the movie, I think.
Did you ever personally have an experience with the superfan that kind of got weird or?
Not exactly like it happens in the movie, but I definitely have been in rooms way past the point where I should have been. And, you know, like a level of intoxication that I shouldn't have been at. And, and seen some things.
Yeah.
And
it's so funny that when, you know, you were going back, I'm like, what can I write about? Like, really, what do I have to say? That's tough.
Yeah.
But you've been writing for a long time.
I think it's become more, it's, you know, the more you do something, I think the better you get at it. But with these Lifetime movies, it was different because we were hired to write them. Me and a buddy of mine were hired to write the movies. So the story, the content was bought, and it was an adaptation of these best friend stories, one of whom killed another. Really good thing to do to your best friend.
I know why we do Hallmark here.
but you know, it's very different, like adapting something and being like, okay, well, this is the broad strokes of the story. How do I turn this into an exciting, you know, way of telling it, where something interesting happens at the end of each act and blah 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 blah. This is more open ended, where, you know, I knew the subject that I wanted to write about, and I think initially I wrote the lead of the script to be this like angsty soap star. And then once I started looking at it kind of from the other side and thinking about it from the fans' point of view, it really opened up. And so there's still like a character that I'm playing that's an angsty soap star. But the fan is the lead, and the story is told through her eyes, and the script, I think, just finally started working a lot better when I figured that out.
Do you like acting or writing better if you had to choose?
I mean, writing is something I think I'm still new at and I'm still learning. Mm-hmm. Acting I've done since I was a little kid in a way. Like I started doing theater, and you know, I grew up in doing high school theater and community theater and all that garbage, and and you know, I studied it in college, and so I think I still consider myself an actor first, but I find it really thrilling, this new writing stuff that I've been doing, and this will be my first time directing. So,
you start
getting drunk on power. You're like, well, I want to tell them how to do it too. Yeah. Like, I don't want the director
to show you.
I'm going to act, I'm going to write, and I'm going to direct.
Yeah, that happened. It got to the point where I was like, I don't want anybody else to direct this. I have it all in my head, and it's my story to tell. So, I feel like I was uniquely positioned to tell this story because I was on the soap opera for so long and felt like this kind of fish out of water. And yeah, this is kind of like my reconciliation with that.
Would you go back to doing daytime?
What I say is, like, I never say never. Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. you know, life takes you and pulls you in different directions. Like, I don't know if after this movie anybody in that realm will have me. But like, you know, like my wife is Irish and we're about to move to Ireland for a year to make, she's a filmmaker and she's making a film in Ireland.
You know, congratulations, because I know you've been married, 2017 you got married, but you have a baby and he's not even a year yet.
Yeah.
You know, so he's still this little tiny thing. So congratulations, you have a lot going on.
You do.
Yeah, a lot going on.
Family, you have this movie coming. Amazing.
But you know,
it's great.
Wife's a filmmaker, so you get...
She understands. Yeah, like we both understand each other. I mean, she's just so incredibly supportive of me kind of going out on a limb and making this film.
That's the Irish nature.
It is. Yeah. Are you Irish?
Yeah, I'm part Irish.
Part Irish.
So our thing was like, go for it.
No,
just
I mean,
do
it's,
it.
You'll it's be really fine. True. I mean, totally. I mean, in a way that sometimes you're like, that's crazy. It's like, just do it. But in a way, like, I don't know that I would have had the courage to kind of go for this in the way that I have if I, you know, first of all, she's just a more experienced filmmaker than me. So I'm going through my shot list with her, and she's like, why do you need that shot? That's, you have a low budget. Like, you don't have time for that shot. And I'm like,
oh, so taking notes,
But no, she's incredibly supportive, and, you know, we both have each other's back, but she's been really, like, make this movie, do it now. And so we have to make it now, because her next movie is filming in France and Ireland early next year. So.
So you've got this window.
Yeah. Have a window, we got to do it.
And when we're talking about support, talk about this fundraising scenario and how fans can get involved with it. And
well, so what, one thing that I think is cool about this movie, if I do say so myself, is that you know, soap fans have been, you know, it's about soap fans. One of our investors, one of our like primary investors, is somebody I met at a soap event, somebody who's just been incredibly supportive to me, named Shelley. If you're listening, you're amazing.
Shelley, you're amazing.
She's absolutely amazing. She started, yeah, anyway, she's great. But, and you know, this, the way that we're going to film this movie is by throwing a real soap opera fan event. It's going to be an authentic experience, although some of the things that people say and do will be scripted. You know, it's going to be legitimate soap stars on stage for the Q&A, signing the autographs,
here
doing the
Los
VIP
Angeles.
Dinners here in Los Angeles.
Okay. Wow.
We're announcing the hotel soon. It's going to be an all-star lineup. We're still locking down a few of the details, but people are going to be very excited by the soap stars that we have on board with
you
this.
You can't give any a name? Yeah.
The only one we have that I can absolutely say is Sean Christian is attached.
I love Sean. Yeah.
Sean is going to be amazing in this part.
Oh my god.
It's like it's not Sean, but he's going to bring all of his humor. He's such a good actor, you know? Like he's a brilliant actor.
He's so funny.
He's really funny, and it's going to be a funny part, and it's a slight character for him too. So I think people are going to be really surprised and excited by what he brings. And then the other few, I have to remain tight-lipped about it for
we
hopefully.
We like mystery. Mystery is good.
Hopefully, in the next couple of weeks, we're working out the deals. So anyway, but it will be this authentic fan event. People will also get an insight into the way a movie works, which a lot of people don't know about, and they'll say, you know, cut and action, and take that back, and do it this way. And some of the people will probably end up being in the movie.
This is kind of blowing my mind, because there's so many things going on at once. You're in a movie, but you're at a real fan event.
Yeah. It's a little...
You're going to have a lot, because this is, you know, this is authentic. These are people who are not used to movie sets.
Yeah,
so it's
but
gonna,
it'll be so much fun.
It's
totally.
Great.
So the way, just like insider look on the way it's going to work, is that we have this real fan event that happens. It's one day of our 13 days of shooting. And then what we're going to do is basically you get all your wide shots and shots of the fans and shots of, like, you know, the crowds and all that sort of thing. And then we're going to kind of recreate those scenes over the next day and go tighter for the tighter shots, do it with a little more nuance, and basically throw the whole soap opera fan event. So if there's people who are like, I want to stick around, I want to, like, get to know the soap stars better from just being on set for like a couple more days, that's totally available to them. But we've launched this Seed and Spark fundraising campaign.
Okay, perfect.
It's on Seed and Spark. The movie is called Fangirl. And there's a little teaser at the beginning. You can see we shot at an event at the Sportsman's Lodge in November. That we kind of wanted to just work out some of the kinks, and we wanted to film this teaser for the fundraiser, so people get a little taste of the style of the movie, and it's just me and Jen in it, and she's kind of waiting in line, and it's kind of just the anticipation of coming up to the person that you're excited to see at one of these events and making eye contact for the first time, and that's all it is. Like that's the teaser, and then it's me being like, ah, Merry Christmas, give us money. So people can. There's different ways to support the film. One of the ways is to buy a ticket to this soap opera fan event that's going to be March 21st in Los Angeles.
Okay.
Details are forthcoming. And there's also lots. If you can't make the fan event, there's lots of other ways to support the film on the Seed and Spark.
So it's Seed and Spark, and then Fangirl.
Yep.
And then they can get involved that way with a possible opportunity of being in a film and going to an actual
That's a win-win.
You know, live fan event. Yeah. Oh my God, it's so great. So
you might even end up saying some lines. Yeah.
Wow. Oh my God.
You're in Los Angeles, you guys.
I know it. You guys need to get on this.
It happens. So I know Fangirl on Twitter, you can go, people can go to Real Fangirl Film on Twitter.
Right. Yeah.
And on Insta, it's
I think it's official. Yeah, you know, all these things are taken, so like you have to get like official.
It's
real.
It's so hard to find.
Fangirl's like a popular word.
Yes, yeah, like got like 62 million hashtags.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
So again, on Twitter at Real Fangirl Film and on Insta at Official Fangirl Film.
Yeah.
Again, go to SeedSpark.
Seed and Spark.
And
we have a Facebook as well. I got banned from Facebook. I don't know why.
Okay.
But so, but like I'm working out, I'm talking to somebody very high level at Facebook and they're working out my, why I've been disabled, I've been banned. I don't know what
I
did.
It's kind of cool though.
I know. I'm like, you know? Bad boy.
Your bad boy's coming out.
I know. Yeah, so hopefully that gets worked out soon because I have, I'm like friends with all these people that I want to know about the event and I'm not able to post it at the moment.
Well, you know, share information with us because we can obviously blast it on our Facebook page that so far hasn't been banned.
Yeah, we are good.
Wow,
we shall see.
Yes.
And I'm shocked.
When you get more information, please let us know.
I will. I'll give you the Steven Spark site.
Okay, great.
And people can watch the video there and if you could put that on blast, that would be awesome.
Yeah, absolutely.
We'll do it.
Cool.
Great. Thank you so much, Blake.
Thank you.
So nice talking to you guys.
So nice
talking
to you.
We are excited.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's great
to
be here.
We're looking forward to it.
This AfterBuzz studio is amazing.
It's
come a long way.
Isn't it cool?
Maria Menounos and Keven Undergaro, this is their dream child.
It's really cool.
And the hosts here, we are so grateful to have this platform.
Because
we love what we do.
It's a great fit.
Yeah. It's a fun job.
Always say we're here to support and promote. So having you and, you know, just
it's
the
great.
Daytime
this
community.
It's great. I really thank you guys for having me.
Well, thank you for coming on.
Yeah, absolute pleasure. Okay, everyone. So that means we are wrapping up for this week. Make sure and stay tuned for another episode of Soap News Weekly next Thursday, 6:15 p.m. We'll see you then.
Bye.
Our founder, Keven Undergaro, and me, Maria Menounos, would like to thank you for tuning in to AfterBuzz TV. Remember, we're not just the first, we're the biggest in the world, and we're the only destination for all your favorite TV shows. Whatever you crave, we've got it. So go to AfterBuzzTV.com and check out our lineup. Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.